Welcome back to The Ed Show. Thanks for watching tonight. You might not believe this story. When Congress goes on summer recess, lawmakers, what do? They traditionally have time to go back and get in touch with their constituents. They host town hall meetings or campaign events in their home districts to hear from voters and remind folks that, you know what, it's all about you. It's a staple of our democracy, unless you're at a Republican event in Dawsonville, Georgia, where a citizen journalist was dragged out simply for recording. Atlanta's NBC station, WXIA, has the story.
I've got this bruise where the deputy was pushing his thumb.
A week later, and Nydia Tisdale is still in pain. She was arrested while covering this public political rally in Dawson County last Saturday.
Ow! That hurts. You're hurting me!
He slammed me up against a countertop and bent me over.
Tisdale says she had permission to shoot video, and for several minutes she was there recording the political speeches. It's not clear when her presence was no longer welcome, but it appears to begin with Insurance Commissioner Ralph Hudgens when he makes this joke about Democratic Senate candidate Michelle Nunn.
I thought I was going to absolutely puke listening to her. I mean, I don't know why you're videotaping, but yes, I said that.
She was later asked to leave, but she refused. Finally, she was forcibly removed by this Dawson County Sheriff's deputy.
It's traumatic. It's emotional. I was doing absolutely nothing wrong. I had a video camera, and to use that much force.
In the video, you can see Dawson County GOP Chairwoman Linda Clay Umberger walk out because she's so upset.
I am sorry that people are treating you this way. This is wrong.
Outrageous at best. Joining me is citizen journalist Nydia Tisdale, and also her lawyer, William Finch. Great to have both of you with us tonight. Nydia, what were you doing to get arrested? Now, I know you just said on that package story that you weren't doing anything, but I want to hear you say, why, you know, what happened? Why were you arrested?
I was sitting at the rally and video recording the speakers, the stump speeches, and someone didn't want me to record and grabbed me and pushed me out and arrested me. It was.
And you had been given permission to record. Is that correct?
Yes, I spoke to an owner when I first arrived, Mrs. Kathy Burt, and she offered me pumpkin pie. And I explained what I do. I follow the candidates along the campaign trail. I film debates. I film meet and greets and rallies, and I post them on YouTube. And then I link to them and put them on my website, which is called aboutforsyth.com, and also put it on Facebook and on Twitter so that voters can hear from their candidates and try to make an educated decision.
So to be very clear, you weren't doing anything here that you haven't done before. You weren't boisterous, you weren't using profanity, you weren't making a scene. None of that was taking place, correct?
Correct. And 3 weeks earlier, I had filmed a similar rally in the city of Roswell, where the same candidates, the slate of candidates, were present, and I filmed unfettered. I had actually a very nice video that I put on YouTube from that rally in Roswell.
Mr. Finch, the arresting officer was later cleared of any wrongdoing. First of all, what's your response to that? And were your client's rights violated here?
Well, we think, first of all, that this investigation that took place was rather quickly done. There were 75 people or more that were present at Burt's farm, and this investigation concluded within 2 days of it being announced. And I believe there are only 2 witnesses that are listed on the police report. I think that's premature. And as to the second part of your question, yes, I believe my client's rights were violated.
So what's your course of action now?
Well, we'll be defending her in the state court of Dawson County on the criminal charges, and we expect to file federal suits.
The governor of Georgia, Nathan Deal, was there. I'm told he was in the front row. Number one, is that correct? And
yes.
Do you think he should have taken action, Nydia? What about that?
Nydia, I don't hold him responsible it was some campaign staffer or handler, one of the people in the entourage, his name is Clint Bearden, who came and told me I had to turn my camera off or leave. And he did not introduce himself. I didn't know his name. I didn't know by what legal authority he had over me. And then another unnamed person likewise came up and made the same order. And before I could even respond, this unnamed man had my arm twisted behind my back and was pushing me out of the tent. And then we went up into the barn. He pushed me into this store area. He slammed me up against the countertop, bent me over, and my camera's still rolling, as you've probably seen the video of it. And he pushed his body up into my body and eventually wrestled the camera out of my hand and grabbed my other hand and pushed it, twisted it behind my back as well. And he was there for quite some time. I kept asking, "What is your name, sir? Identify yourself." He did not provide any of that information. I had no knowledge of who he was, by what authority he had to remove me or to ask me to stop recording, because I'd already spoken to the owner when I first arrived and several of the candidates, and no one objected to me video recording.
What does this say, Nydia, about this kind of treatment? What does it say about the Republican Party there in Georgia?
I don't know what it says about the Republican Party, Mr. Schultz, but I think that the campaign staff gets a little overzealous and overprotective of their candidate, and I was no threat to anyone. I'm simply there with a video camera. It's a little tiny video camera, and to treat me with that much force, to shove me out of a campaign rally that was advertised as open to the public in the local newspaper and also on Facebook, it was uncalled for. It was terrifying. And this was on a farm in Dawson County, a pumpkin patch, where kids go to buy pumpkins and take hay rides. So I certainly didn't feel like I was under any threat of being assaulted in a pumpkin patch when it wasn't even Halloween. It was absolutely terrifying. I thought I would be safe at a place like that.
Nydia, let's see that camera again. Hold that up. I mean, that's somewhat of a most people don't have those kinds of cameras unless they're going to use it for some kind of professional work. Mr. Finch, it's very clear what your client was doing, and she's got a pattern of doing this. What are your chances of being successful in reopening this investigation and having some justice on this, seeing that from the evidence, from what I can see, Nydia was somewhat brutalized?
Well, I don't see how we will ever be successful with the investigation that's taken place so far. I mean, it was conducted by Sheriff Billy Carlisle in Dawson County. I don't foresee any success there. Now, if you're going to ask if an outside agency will come in and reach a different conclusion, I think that can happen.
Okay. Keep up the good work. This is what America is all about. You're supposed to be able to go into crowds and do whatever you want, and you know, within the law, which you clearly did, and they gave you no reason as to why you were arrested. It's really a travesty that this unfolded. Nydia Tisdale, thank you for joining us tonight. William Finch, her representative, I appreciate your time as well.